And with just one correction, our propeller is now balanced.
Hi, this is Yasmin from Tidy Robotics, and today we're going to show you how to balance your propeller on your flight stand.
Before you balance your propeller, we recommend balancing your motor in disc mode first to ensure it's well balanced. Once your propeller is installed and your flight stand is connected, open the flight stand software and enter your license key in the setup menu. If you haven't purchased one yet, you can contact our sales team using the link in the description. Make sure your ESC and powertrain are mapped in the powertrain mapping tab. In the manual control tab, we set the motor rate limiter to a maximum acceleration of 100 microseconds per second. Then we navigate to the balancing tab. Click New Balancing Session and enter your test parameters. You can name your test as well as the operator, motor, and propeller you're using. Then map each of your readings for rotation speed, vibration, and ESC throttle to the flight stand you are using. Enter your rotor mass, which includes all the rotating parts of your motor, plus your propeller, adapter, and fasteners. Next is the operating speed, which should be the RPM at which you intend to operate during a real flight. The correction radius is the distance from the center of the propeller at which you will place your correction weight. We are placing the weight towards the end of the blade as less mass is required to achieve the desired correction. The quality grade describes the ISO balance quality you wish to set for your pass-fail criteria. The default grade is 6.3, which is commonly used for propellers in the industry. Click Create and activate the ESC for your initial run. During the initial run, you spin the propeller as is so the software can begin to characterize it. Drag the throttle up until you achieve your target RPM. The software will then tell you how much weight to add to your propeller for your trial run, which is used to calibrate the balancing algorithm before recommending a final correction. The trial weight does not need to be exact, but get it close and enter the actual weight installed in the software. Make sure to turn off power to your system before approaching the propeller. The trial weight is added to blade 1 of your propeller, which you can define at this step. If you prefer to minimize the effect of correction on your lift and thrust generation, it is recommended to place the correction weight closer to the center hub. For propellers with more than 2 blades, check out our video where we balance a 3-blade propeller, link in the description below. After adding and recording your trial weight, turn on your power and increase your throttle to your target RPM. Then click Capture. The system will recommend adding a correction weight of 0.2772 grams to blade 2 of our propeller. Remember to turn off the power to your system before approaching the propeller, and make sure to remove your trial weight before adding your correction weight. Enter the actual correction weight that you measured and select the blade that it was added to. This is added at the correction radius we specified when configuring the test. Then run a final spin of the propeller and click Capture when you reach your target RPM. In most cases, you will now get a green check mark next to your final quality grade, indicating you are within tolerance. In some cases, it may suggest an additional correction weight to achieve a passing balance. In the Report tab, you can see a report of your balancing parameters and results. And back on the Balancing homepage, you will see a log of all your tests and their results. Thanks for watching our tutorial on how to balance a propeller with your flight stand. If you found this content useful, don't forget to like and subscribe, and check out our other videos on propeller balancing and testing.